Welcome, everybody. We thank God for being here one more time. We are just so excited to know that you're out there listening and ready to receive a word from the Lord, because certainly we know our God is the one who can always deliver a word for us that will bless us and give us strength in these trying times in which we live. But we know our God is just an awesome God, and He is able to do anything that needs to be done. We just give glory to His name. And we want to welcome all of you, especially our Southtown Apostolic Church family, as well as those of you listening in other parts of the community. And we want you to just let go and let God have His way. Let's pray at this time. Lord Jesus, we thank you, Lord, and we give praise to your name that you have blessed us and allowed us, Lord, to have this privilege as well as this opportunity to receive a word from you. And we ask, Lord, that you would bless us through the power of your word. Send down your word, Lord. Bless the hearers of your word. Let not anyone, Lord, that receives a word from you, Lord, be lacking, but let them, Lord, be touched and ministered to through the power of your word. Now you send down your word, bless us, in Jesus' name we pray. We certainly thank God, we give God praise that he is still on the throne and he is yet doing great things in the lives of his people, and we certainly give him praise for that. We give him praise because we realize that when we can't count on anything else, we can always count on God. He is our sustaining power, and he is our keeping power. One writer said, if it had not been for the Lord, who was on our side. And that's how I feel today. And I know many of you feel the same way, that if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, where would we be? Amen. If it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, we would be going on, but God has sustained us and kept us, and we certainly praise his name and give glory to his name for that. We want to also encourage all of you as we go forward and as we continue to allow God to get us through this pandemic that we're in the middle of. But what I want to say to you before we, as we go forward, and that is that I want to encourage all of you to take seriously the CDC guidelines for keeping yourselves healthy. It doesn't matter what age you are, how young you are, how old you are. This coronavirus does not discriminate. And so we ask you to be safe, to be careful. Wear your mask. Practice social distancing. Amen. Do what you have been requested to do. And if you do your part, God will do his part. But if you don't do your part, I don't know how you expect God to jump in and do it all for you, because God helps those who help themselves. So stay safe and be safe. Wear your mask. Amen. Social distance. Sanitize your hands. Amen. And don't go in large crowds. Be blessed, because when God gets us through this thing, we're going to have some church. Amen. We're going to have some church before then, but we're really going to have some church when God brings us through. God is going to do a great work with those who are willing to allow him to get them through this. Those who are willing to have a closer walk with him, God is going to use you to be a part of this great end time revival that God is going to bring on the scene when we get through this coronavirus. So be tough. Hang tough. Do what you know you're supposed to do. Let God keep you healthy while you do what you're supposed to do. And we're going to go forward in Jesus' name. So I encourage you, take care of yourself, and God will bless you. I want to also talk about the service schedule. Next Sunday, we're looking for all the members of Southtown Apostolic Church who can to participate in our drive-up service on next Sunday. Next Sunday, at 10:30 a.m., we are looking for you. We're looking for you to come to the drive-up service, and let's fellowship together on the parking lot of Southtown Apostolic Church on next Sunday. And we want to encourage you to come and participate. We ask all of those of you who have a mask to bring your mask. You don't have to wear your mask in the car, but we do know that we're going to be greeting you, First Lady and myself, and we would love for you to have a mask when we come to the car to praise God with you for a quick minute. And also, we're going to have lunch provided next Sunday where you can eat lunch in your car and hear the word and hear the singing and just be blessed of the Lord, and it won't cost you a dime. Bandana's Barbecue is going to be providing our lunches next Sunday. So you will have leaders of the church calling you to get the number of people in your family that are coming with you so we can make sure we have enough for everyone who comes out on next Sunday. Amen. Our parking lot drive-up service, that's the next best thing to us being in the sanctuary. So come on out and fellowship with us on next Sunday. And then we will be live streaming on the 23rd and the 30th. We will live stream on next Sunday too, but we want you to come on to the parking lot service where we can see you and you can see us on next Sunday. And so throughout the rest of August, we will be live streaming from the sanctuary. On our Bible class, we will be posting our Bible class, as we said, on every Tuesday. We will have a video lesson, or we will have this scripture for you to study for the week for your Bible class. So please study your word. God's word is our sustaining power, and it is our keeping power. And our word will give us strength. Our word will just help us to get us through, Lord, the tough times that we may be facing. But the word is a powerful source that we can use for our strength. So get in the word and let the word bless you. And by way of talking about getting in the word, please don't set aside your devotional times, your Bible study time, your prayer time. Have a time set aside where you can pray and talk to God, read your Bible, and be still for a moment and let God talk back to you. And we'll all be blessed as we go forward in Jesus' name. We want to talk about giving. We want to thank God for all of those saints of God who have just continued to be steadfast, unmovable in your faithfulness and your giving. Amen. We thank God for you, all those of you who haven't missed a beat by being faithful in your tithing. We thank God for you. We thank God for those of you who haven't missed a beat. Continue to give your offerings regularly. Amen. To support God's work and to do the things that God would call for us to do with the ministry of this church. You're part of it. Everything we do, you're part of it. Your commitment, your financial commitment to this church helps make the difference in the lives of people that we minister to. And we thank God for you. And for those of you who haven't been faithful, I want to know, what are you waiting on to start? Because God has a blessing preserved and reserved for you. When you want to get it together and honor him with your finances, he will shower down a blessing upon you. He will bless your money if you bless his money. Amen. So let's do our part. Let's let go and let God have his way in our giving. You can always give through Givelify. You can always use the PayPal account, or you can always use the mail, P.O. Box 725, Southtown Apostolic Church, Mount Vernon, Illinois. Amen. So we thank God for each and every one of you in your giving and all that you're doing. Let's keep on doing it for the glory of God. At this time, Sister Randy Gordon and First Lady Shirley Gordon are coming with a selection, and we certainly thank God as they come. We just give praise to the name of the Lord as they come to give us a word and song today in Jesus' name. And also Deacon Stephen Gordon is going to assist on with the musicians, amen, to bless us real good today in Jesus' name. We thank God. We give God praise. So we want you to just listen and let God speak to us through a word and song. Let's say amen at this time. Thank you. Verses 1 through 4, and also the 27th number of Psalms. Amen. 68th number of Psalms. And the Word of God reads in Psalm 68 and 1. It says, "Let God arise, and let his enemies be scattered. Let them also that hate him flee before him." And for a subject that I want you to think on today, the subject is, let God arise and our enemies be scattered. Let God arise and our enemies be scattered. Amen. I think it's very important to realize the definition of what an enemy is. An enemy is anything that tries to harm or weaken you. Anything that actively opposes you or is hostile towards you. That's what an enemy is. And that is certainly the definition of the devil, because the Bible says that the thief cometh but to kill, steal, and destroy. And anything and anybody that he uses is going to kill, steal, or destroy. But the Word of God tells us in this 68th number of Psalms, this is a song of celebration, amen, Because at this particular time, the people of God are in the process of bringing the Ark of the Covenant back to Israel. Hallelujah. And you know that the Ark of the Covenant is the presence of God. Amen. And in knowing that the Ark of the Covenant is coming back into Jerusalem, we talked on last week or the week before, I don't remember exactly which one it was, about how when the Ark of the Covenant was out before Joshua, when they were fighting and marching around Jericho, that they knew that the presence of the Lord was there. Amen. And so they were saying, let God arise. And when God arises, our enemies will be scattered. And God is, we have to realize that we have to have the confidence that God is, he is a competent God, and he knows the needs of his people. And when he arises, our enemies will be scattered. When Jesus rose from the dead, his enemies were scattered. All of the people that counted him out because they saw him hanging on Calvary's cross, and even death and grave that made their agreement about how if one got him, the other one would keep him, but they still couldn't stop him from getting up. He rose, and when he got up, his enemies were scattered. The enemy, amen, of sin and death, amen, was destroyed through him getting up from the grave. And so the Lord wants us to realize that if we, his people, will allow him to arise in our lives, and if we want God to rise up in our life, we have to work on our relationship with God to assure that his presence is with us and that his presence is at work in our lives. The word of God through David said that when God arises, our enemies will be scattered just like the smoke that the wind drives away. You ever seen a fire burning and the smoke going up and the wind blowing? The smoke just disappears into the air because of the wind. And it also talks about how that our enemies will be just like wax melting before the fire. Our enemies will perish at the presence of God. Amen. And we all know that it is a known fact that no sin can stand in God's presence. And this is the reason why it was such a difficult time back during the time when the high priest had to go beyond the veil once a year to offer up the sacrifice for the sins of the people. Because if the high priest had sin in his life, he fell dead in the presence of God. So sin cannot live in the presence of God. And when God arises, remember we said earlier that our enemies are anyone that wants to harm or weaken us. And if anyone is working to harm or weaken God's people, they've got to be of the devil. Amen. And we realize that, amen, he is the one that's driving people with his evil intentions to kill, steal, and destroy. But the word of God tells us that if we let God arise, the righteous ought to be glad and rejoice before God, amen, because in his name we have the victory. Amen. We have the victory when we have God arising in our lives. And if you want him to arise, you've got to spend time in his word. You want him to arise, you've got to spend time in prayer. You want him to arise, you got to turn the plate over sometime if you want God to arise. And if God arises in your life and in our lives, our enemies will be scattered. Amen. And we ought to rejoice because we know that In the name of Jesus, we have the victory, and we are to rejoice at the arrival of his presence. Amen. We are to rejoice and be glad that he is present. Every time you feel his Holy Ghost power moving on the inside, you are to rejoice and be glad and say that the Lord is present. And I give hallelujah glory to his name. Amen. I'm not the same when he arises. Amen. And does, Lord, does a work in my life. Amen. We are to rejoice and have exceedingly joy at his presence. Amen. The Bible says we ought to extol him. And extol means we ought to praise him enthusiastically. We ought to praise him like we want to praise him. We ought to praise him like he deserves our praise. We ought to praise him because he's due our praise. Amen. We ought to extol him. Hallelujah. Extol him because our enemies didn't win. Extol him because he put the devil on the run. Extol him because he's keeping us in the midst of it all. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let God arise. Is there anybody out there listening today that will say it's time for God to arise in my life? Hallelujah. Because we realize, amen, we know that God, when he arises, everything will be all right. Amen. We have to think about when God arises and think about the wonderful works that he has brought about in our lives. See, David and them, they realized, amen, what God had done. Israel realized what God had done, how he allowed them to survive in the wilderness, how he gave them victory over their enemies, how he led them with his presence before him. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How God was able to see them through. Amen. How God is in control and God is the director of all the affairs of all the nations. You may look at where we are today and not understand it. You might be puzzled and perplexed, but I want you to know that the God we serve, he is in charge and in control, and he knows what's going on. He is not caught by surprise. He is not perplexed. He is not troubled, but God knows exactly where we are. So we ought to extol him because we know that he is in charge of the affairs of all the nations. God is in charge. We ought to extol him. He's done it before, and he'll do it again. We ought to extol him when we think about where he brought us from. We ought to extol him when we think about how he has kept us. We ought to extol him when we think about what could have been and what should have been. We ought to extol him because we realize he is the one who is keeping us. He's the one leading us, and we know that through him and with him, everything will be all right. David said in the 27th number of Psalms, he said, "The Lord is my light." You may not be able to know the way, but God is the light of the way. He is the light. He is the lamp unto our feet. And a light unto our path. He is our light. Amen. If you want to see your way, you got to look toward the light. Because the light is with the way to show you the way. So you need light in your life. Jesus will light up your life. David said, "He's my light and he's my salvation. Whom shall I fear?" Amen. The Lord is the strength of my life. He is my strength. I'm not trying to do it on my strength, but I'm leaning on Jesus. And I know that everything will be all right. I'm not afraid of the stronghold that the devil tries to put against us because God is our strength. when the wicked, amen, when the wicked, amen, when those who are being used through demonic forces at work to try to do harm or try to do hurt, they are enemies. They are the enemies of God, working against God's plan, working against God's people, working against the peace of God's people, working against God's people's joy. But God said, don't worry about it. I am your light, and I'm your salvation. And you ain't got to be afraid of nobody, because I'm on your side. The Lord said, when the wicked, when the no good devil people come up against you, when your enemies, people who are working, people who are hostile against you, people who are actively opposing you, people are trying to do harm to you, amen, the Lord said, I will give you the victory. I want you to know that every enemy is not just people, but there's all kinds of enemies that tries to stop God's people. There's enemies of your mind that will try to make you think crazy, make you give up, make you be depressed, make you have no hope, make you lose your joy. That's the enemy of your mind. But we've got victory over every enemy because the Lord says he is our light, he is our salvation. Whom shall we fear? He will arise and put our enemies on the run. When you felt like giving up, let God arise. When you feel like you can't go on, let God arise. When you feel troubled, let God arise. When you need understanding, let God arise. When you don't think you can make it, let God arise. When God arises, troubled mind gotta go. When God arises, depression gotta go. When God arises, worry gotta go. When God arises, stress gotta go. When God arises, our enemies will be scattered wherever they are. You name the enemy, it doesn't matter. God gave us victory over our enemies. They're enemies of the mind, enemies of your peace, enemies of your faith, but God, when he arises, our enemies will be scattered. Hallelujah. We give glory to his name. Amen, amen. When the wicked, even my foes and my enemies came up and they attacked me, when they put, amen, all kinds of plots against me, when they encamped against me, my heart will not fear. Though war should rise against me, I've got confidence that God's going to see us through. I've got confidence that I'll wait on God, because everything will be all right. And I give glory to his name. I don't care how big the enemy might think he is. I will not fear, because God is on my side. Though a war would rise up against me, I've got confidence that God's going to see us through. I've got confidence that everything's going to be all right. I've got confidence that in the time of trouble, when I don't seem like I'm going to be all right, the Lord will hide me in the pavilion of the secret place of his tabernacle. He will hide me. He will set me up on a rock. And now my head is going to be lifted up above mine enemies. They look for me to be destroyed. But God said, rise up. Rise up and give me praise. Rise up and get your joy back. Rise up and put a smile on your face. Rise up and have peace in your mind. Lord, let us know that our head will be raised up above our enemies. He said, therefore, Sing songs of praise. Sing songs of joy. Let God have his way. Because when God arises, our enemies will be scattered. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The devil, he don't like it. When we give God the praise, he don't like it. When you say I'm not giving up, he don't like it. When you say this is a day that the Lord has made, I will rejoice and be glad in it. He don't like it when you're in a struggle and when you're in a storm and you say I'm not going to wait till the storm is over. I'm going to praise God now. I'm going to give him glory now. He don't like it when you're in the fight of your life, but you get a song on your heart that says, I'm so glad that trouble don't last always. Hallelujah. You get a song that say, I'm not going to wait till my struggle's over. I'm not going to wait till my storm is over. I'm not going to wait till Corona is over. I'm going to praise him now. I'm going to give him glory now. I'm going to give him victory now. I'm going to wave my hand now. I'm going to sing my song now because I know God has arisen. Our enemies will be scattered. This enemy that's on the scene shaking the whole world. But if we let God arise, our enemy will be scattered. If you let him arise, let him rise in the morning, rise in the noonday, rise in the midnight hour, rise when you feel like it, rise when you don't feel like it, rise when you got strength, rise when you don't have strength. Let God arise, and our enemies will be scattered. Hallelujah. The Lord said, wait on him. Be of good courage. Wait on him. Be of good courage. You say, well, I don't know whether I have good courage or not. But when you're waiting on God and you got good courage, you can sing a song. When you're waiting on God and you got good courage, you can clap your hands. When you're waiting on God and you got good courage, you can give him a praise. When you're waiting on God and you got good courage, you can encourage somebody else. You can bless somebody else. You can inspire somebody else. You can push somebody else. You can give somebody else hope. When you're of good courage and you're waiting on God and you know that God is, he's worth the wait. He is worth the wait. He's worth waiting on. He's worth hanging on. He's worth holding on. Because ain't nobody like him. Wait on him. Wait on him. When the wait is over, a shout is coming on. When the wait is over, victory will arise. When the wait is over, joy. When the wait is over, normal life back. When the wait is over, praises back. When the wait is over, victory back. When the wait is over, the church is back. When the wait is over, healing is back. When the wait is over, victory is back. When the wait is over, everything will be all right. Let God arise. Don't let everything else arise, but let God arise. When confusion wants to arise, when hate wants to arise, when disappointment wants to arise, when discouragement wants to arise, let God arise. And our enemies will be scattered. The Lord said in Exodus chapter number 23, he said that if we do all that he said, y'all hear me? The Lord said in Exodus 23, verse 22, that if you do all I say, I will be an enemy to your enemies. Did y'all hear that? The Lord said, when you obey me and when you do what I tell you to do, your enemy is my enemy. In other words, the people that's fighting you, they're not just fighting you, but they're fighting me. They might be able to beat you, but they can't beat me. So if your enemy is my enemy, if you do what I tell you to do. He said, and I will oppose those who oppose you. He said, they can't be against you. Hallelujah. Without being against God. He said, I'm opposing them who oppose you. If they against you, God said, I'm against them. If they your enemy, God said, they my enemy. What a blessing to know that our God will fight for us. He will arise on our behalf. He will arise so that your enemy is his enemy. He will arise so that if they oppose you, they oppose him. Hallelujah. And the Lord said in the 138th number of Psalms, he says, the word says, though I walk in the midst of trouble, you preserve my life. Y'all hear me? The Lord said, I got you. I got you. You're in the midst of trouble. You're in the midst of a storm. But you know what the Lord said? He said, I'm preserving you. I'm preserving you. I'm keeping you. I'm seeing you through. I'm arising in your life. I got you. I got your family. I got you in my hands. And what did the Lord say? He said, we are in his hands. Do y'all hear me? And he said, no devil can pluck us out. Hallelujah. We're at a good place, church. We're at a good place. Where is that good place, Pastor? That good place is we're in the hands of God. He says, they're in my hands. And he says that he will preserve our life. You stretch forth your hand against the anger of my foes. With the right hand, you save me. In other words, the Lord said, I stretch forth my hands against the enemies of my people. And I save them. Hallelujah. Let God arise and let his enemies and let our enemies be scattered. God will get up and scatter our enemies. Amen. God will take care of his people. And we ought to worship him with joy because he is on our side. So are you going to let God arise and let your enemies be scattered? Let him arise by giving him glory. Let him arise by obeying his word. Let him arise by spending time in your Bible. Let him arise by spending time on your knees. Let him arise by turning your plate over. Let him arise by giving him praise, extol him, giving him enthusiastic praise. Don't praise him like it's a hassle. Don't praise him like it's a chore, but praise him because you want to praise him. And you know that he is good. And he is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Don't worry about your enemies. Just let God arise. Let him arise. Let him up. Let God get up in your life. Let God stand up in your life. Yes. Let God be out front in your life. Yes. And the Lord said, our enemies will be scattered. Amen. When we let God arise. Hallelujah. Now is the time to let him arise. Somebody's waiting on you to encourage them. Somebody's waiting on you to give them hope. Somebody's waiting on you to let them know it's going to be all right. You can't do it if you don't let God arise. Yes. But if you let God arise, you can be blessed. Yes. And you can be a blessing. Ah, hallelujah. You can be blessed and you can be a blessing. Everything you put your hand to do would be a blessing to somebody. If you would just let God arise and let our enemies be scattered. No matter where our enemies are, the Lord said they will be scattered if we let him arise. Be encouraged, church. Get that closer walk to the Lord. Don't just be complacent and take it lightly, but get a closer walk with the Lord. Let him rise up in your life. Hallelujah. David said in the word of God, he said, Lord, he said, rise up and slay thine enemies. Hallelujah. You ought to let God rise up in you so we can slay our enemies, wherever they may be. Our enemies, natural and spiritual. Amen. Spiritual wickedness in high places. Let God rise up. Amen. Powers and principalities, the rules of darkness of this world. We need to let God rise up and let our enemies be scattered. It's all right to be concerned and hear about stuff and talk about how bad it is, but what are you going to do about it? The way we fight is to let God rise. Let him rise up in our lives. If the church will let God arise all over this world, we will put the devil on the run. God bless you. Be encouraged. Hold on and hang on. Amen. God has got us. And we give glory to his name. Yes. God bless you. God keep you. We're looking for all of you on next Sunday, 10:30 a.m. on the parking lot at the church. Amen. Come on out and be blessed. And until then, God bless you in Jesus' name.